So basically the Letaget procedure is one where you go through a standard deltopectoral approach. A coracoid graft is taken along with the conjoint tendons. Then a split is made in the subscapularis muscle. Through this split, the coracoid graft is fixed to the area of the glenoidal bone loss, and that provides the augmentation for the bony loss. And the conjoint tendon also provides a sling effect, which gives the stabilization for the shoulder instability. So coming to my study consisted of 28 patients, which was selected by various inclusion and exclusion criteria. Once they were selected, we did a functional scoring for all these patients, and we obtained x-rays and CT scans for all these patients. And only those patients who had more than 15% or a critical glenoidal bone loss were selected for operative procedure. The operative procedure, as described previously, was done for all these patients. The only difference was that we took a mini incision instead of the normal longer deltopectoral approach. These are a few post-operative x-rays where you can see the coracoid, which is removed, and it is placed with the help of 4.5 cc screws in the position of the glenoidal bone loss. Post-operatively, we did a functional scoring for these patients using two functional scores. The first one being the Duplay wall stability score, and the second one was the Oxford shoulder instability score. And for radiological evaluation, we took x-rays and CT scans of these patients. In the CT scan, we looked for three major criteria as described by Kloss. The first one was the graft position, which was done according to the glenoidal height. The second one was the alpha angle of the screw in the axial CT scan cuts, which is the angle between the shaft of the screw and the subchondral glenoid bone. And the last one was the fusion of the graft looking at the peculiar trabecular pattern. As you can see, that is how we did the glenoidal height and the graft position, and the axial cuts of the CT showing the alpha angle. These are the results of my study. When we did the results of the functional outcomes, both the scoring system gave a statistical improvement. However, the only parameter, that is the mobility score in the Duplay walls, was the one which was not improved statistically. And in looking at the radiological criteria, all three of them fit in the proper parameters given as per the Kloss criteria. The major two complications which we saw in our study were basically, one was the loss of external rotation post-operatively, which we thought was due to the longer immobilization period which is given to these patients, and so we transitioned to the usage of a sling for a shorter duration. And also many studies have shown that it is affected majorly because of the subscapularis muscle handling which is done in the operative procedure. And the second major complication we came through was that of the graft resorption, which was at the rate of 89.2% seen in our study. And a peculiar pattern of graft resorption, as you can see here, was that at the equator it was seen more, and this was majorly attributed because the major biomechanical load is on the inferior aspect of the graft, and therefore there is resorption towards the equator. Thus, to conclude my study, the results of modified Letaget have given a satisfactory clinical as well as radiological outcome. However, the only two major concerns which we had during our study were that of restricted external rotation and abduction, and the graft resorption, which were the main concerns. That's all. Thank you.